I came out of that ruck of, or rebounded from that ruck of what the trade center had left me. You know what I'm saying? I started to, you know, find my way, find my path back to where I wanted to be physically. So that was the start of the change of my approach of how I was going to approach my fitness.
Okay. All right. And certainly mobility is, you know, paramount as you get older. So what is, give me an idea or give our listeners an idea of what functional fitness looks like in the fire service. I mean, again, what would a program look like to a firefighter that wants to, you know, start to go down this path that you're speaking of?
So I've never like programmed it specifically for what I would do at work. You know, like, so I would look at, what do we need, right? We need cardiovascular fitness, right? So that's going to be the baseline, right? Because that's going to allow our recoveries to happen. That's going to, you know, if you have a higher cardiovascular fitness, you just have a higher ability to work. Along with that, we're going to need some type of muscular power, because we need power at times, and muscular endurance. So if you're looking at what an ideal program should be for a firefighter, it's a very balanced program, because we have to do so many different things. Does it mean if I can deadlift 500 pounds, is that going to be a benefit? Well, it might, but how much does a guy weigh? How much are we going to really be picking up? So it's not being, you know, maximal strength type of strong. It's being above average, in a balanced type of approach. So you're not overdoing anything, because overdoing something can lead to an injury as well. So I kind of, what really helped me was getting into activities. So I started doing, and this is the road I went down. I started to do stuff like adventure races and things like that. So I would train and then have an outlet for my training that's not just the fire service, because it's very hard to measure how well you're doing at a fire. Either you feel good afterwards, you feel good or after. It's hard to put metrics on it. You know what I'm saying? Well, how much did you exert? Well, now you can with the whoop.
But sure.
I found that if I was training and had an outlet for performance that was measurable, that it provided more motivation. And I think that's what a lot of guys will find, is that stay motivated. It's not easy to stay motivated for 20, 30 years. So like I did stuff like Spartan races, you know, I would do half marathons. We did the Ironman 1 year. So just, we do some very long hikes, things where you can kind of test yourself, you know, making yourself that whole statement of being, find comfort in being uncomfortable. I wouldn't just wait for that sensation for a fire to present that with me, but develop it in your training so that now you're developing that skill of being able to work when you're not feeling optimal. And then when it happens at a fire, you're ready for it.